Thank you for clicking on a video about insurance. Hi, my name is Michelle. This is Actuarial, my actuarial YouTube channel. You've made it to a very weird niche on the internet. I'm not gonna lie to you. I'm a fellow of the Casualty Actuarial Society, a fellow of the Canadian Institute of Actuaries, currently working as a personal lines pricing actuary at a major car and home insurer here in Toronto, Canada. So if I asked you, what are the two main ways that insurance companies make money, would you know? I'm gonna give you the answer because we can't have like a live dialogue right now in this pre-recorded video. The first way is by selling insurance. That's pretty obvious. You sell the policies and you try to make money off of it. And then the second way is by investing the money that you make from selling the policies. Like, insurance companies are a financial institution. We collect large amounts of money, and then we take that money, we invest it, and then we make money off of those investments. That part of it is not what we're gonna talk about today. Today we're really gonna be focusing on the part of actually selling the insurance policies, making money by selling insurance. If you want the real proper insurance term for this, it would be called underwriting income or underwriting profit. We earn income by underwriting policies, and then we earn profit off of that underwriting policy if, you know, everything goes to plan. I mentioned it before and I'll mention it again. The fun actuarial challenge with insurance is the timing problem. First you sell the insurance policy, then maybe someone has an insurance claim. We don't know how much that's gonna be, we don't know when the claim is gonna happen, and then along the way there's expenses that come up, and then maybe if it's priced properly, we get some profit. When I sell you the car insurance policy, I don't know if you're gonna have no claim, probably, or if you're gonna have a $300 claim, or if you're gonna have a $10 million claim. I don't know how much this is gonna cost in the end. We sell the policy first, and then we find out the expenses later. I like to talk about this in a timeline because it makes it more clear, at least in my mind, of what's sort of happening, but if we're gonna get mathy about it, let's just shove an equal sign. So premium is equal to losses or claims. I use the terms interchangeably, basically the amount they're paying when someone gets into a car accident or when someone's house burns down, plus expenses, plus profit. That, my friends, is the fundamental insurance equation. It's a reserving actuary's job to make sure that we set aside enough money to pay off our claim liabilities. Depending on the type of policy, it can take a year, 3 years, 10 years before we know how much the total claims are gonna be on a given policy. And it's the pricing actuary's job, it's my job, to make sure that we collect enough premium in the first place. A pricing actuary does two main things. One is price segmentation, figuring out that I charge this person $1,000 and this person $5,000 because this person is less risky and this person is more risky. Not what we're talking about. The next thing that the pricing actuary does is make sure that we collect enough premium in aggregate. We do this with rate indications, and rate level indications come from the fundamental insurance equation. Isn't that nice? Aren't we tying things back? Unless you're a new insurance startup, there are already insurance prices. Like, I don't have to touch them. People can keep selling insurance policies for as long as they want. Next year, they can still sell a whole bunch of policies, and we will collect a whole bunch of premium. People will have claims, we will have to pay out those claims, the expenses will happen, and then the part of the equation that will either dip up or down is going to be that profit part. Profit can be very positive, or profit can be very negative. It really just depends on the balance between premium and losses. If we sell $100 million worth of premium, but have $200 million worth of losses, that seems like a whole lot of negative profit. What we do is we use the fundamental insurance equation to look at the balance, to look at how profitable we expect to be. I'm not going to teach you all about indications today, but just know that it's a way for us to know, do we need to raise prices or do we need to lower prices to keep this equation in balance. There are a couple other key metrics from the fundamental insurance equation that I do want to teach you about, but what we have to do is we have to take this equation and divide it all by premium. So if we look at the left hand side, premium divided by premium is 100% of premium. We're saying this is the whole pie. This is 100% of all the premium that we got. And then if we look at the right hand side of the equation, we're saying, where is this premium going? What percent of the premium is being paid towards losses? What percent of the premium is being paid towards expenses? What percent of the premium is being kept as profit? If I sell $100 in premium, we have $60 in losses, $30 in expenses, and $10 in profit. That 60% is called a loss ratio. The loss ratio tells us how much of the premium is going towards paying claims. The expense ratio in this case would be 30%. 30% of premium is going towards expenses, and then 10% is going into profit. That would be a really nice idyllic situation. That does sometimes happen. A combined ratio is the combination of the loss ratio and the expense ratio. So 100% of premium goes to the combined ratio, which is losses and expenses, plus the profit ratio. Now, if the combined ratio is below 100, then that means you've made profit. If the combined ratio is above 100, that means that you have not made any profit. As soon as your combined ratio goes above 100%, then your profits become negative because there's no more premium to allocate towards profit. Lower combined ratio means more profit, means more better. As an insurance company, we don't aim for excessive profits. That's not the goal. The goal is not to gouge people out of as much money as possible, but we definitely want a combined ratio below 100. If you want to hear about how reserving actuaries set aside enough money to pay off the insurance claims, do click that video right here. Thank you for calling. I love you guys. Thumbs up. Bye.